Bike Club Holiday Special is coming at you. It's hot and it's juicy. Bike Club Holiday Special, baby, it's coming at you and it's super fruity. Bike Club Holiday Special, baby, Star Wars. You're like, wait, Holiday Special? Star Wars? Tommy, yes. It's on Disney. It's their fault. They started, when Force Awakens came out, they started dropping this shit around Christmas. So guess what? Star Wars, holiday spirit, how are we? They're one and the same. It don't matter no more.
They made a baby.
Yep, bingo. So when it's the holiday season, you might as well watch Star Wars because it's magical, it's sweet, and it's dope, and it reminds you of the holiday spirit. Because all this shit gets released now. We got Mando. We're coinciding with that. If you're watching that, we got season finales coming up. We got penultimate finale. All kinds. It's getting freaking dope. So yeah, holiday special. But before we move on to more holiday sweetness, let's get ready for, or I guess, acknowledge the first holiday special.
Yes.
Norwal versus sea leopard.
Damn. Why?
It. Leopard seal.
Why?
Leopard seal. What do you guys think? Everyone, leopard seal?
Wait, the leopard seal won?
Yeah.
I'm so seal. Excited! You didn't tell me.
It was bigger, I guess, than I anticipated.
It's not just bigger, it's like muscular and like intelligent and all those other
things.
Well,
regardless, everyone thought that it was.
The movies,
stupid
man.
Leopard seal.
You have to watch those movies.
But who cares? Because I couldn't care less. Because guess what?
I care.
It's Star Wars time, baby. Look at this set. Look at all this shit here. They were like, oh, do you have anything Star Wars you could dress the set with? What do you think? Take a look. Yeah, take a look there. Take a look over there. Take a look there. Bam, 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 bam. Thank you, ma'am. I had to leave shit at home. I have so much stuff here. So yeah, Star Wars Holiday Special. This is gonna be a good fight. This is a fight I've always wanted to do. It's been a debate my entire life. I've asked people.
It's been a debate your entire life.
Yes,
that's
I've asked
very
people
strange.
This question. Shut up. I asked people this question because it's a good one. It's a fun fight that I think would be a good battle. Are you ready?
All right.
Star Wars Holiday Christmas Kwanzaa Hanukkah Special. Life Day. That's the Star Wars Holiday Life Day Special. That's
a
what this
life
really
day?
Is. From the Star Wars Holiday Special, like the actual Star Wars Holiday Special.
Oh, that's really funny.
Whatever. Life Day Special, Jawas versus Ewoks, go.
Jawas versus Ewok, go.
Jawas versus Ewoks, Jawas.
Go.
Jawas.
Ja-no.
What? Did you laugh at me? You laughed at my response.
No, I said ja-no, like no.
No. I get that, but like.
Okay, so why are your stupid Jawas gonna win? Because they're not.
They're not stupid, they're really smart. That's the reason
really?
Why, they're really
they're
smart.
They're just a bunch of swindling traitors. That's all they are.
Okay, first of all, it takes a lot of skill to swindle. First of all,
a bunch of rapscallions. Don't get it twisted. They don't know what to do except
they're amazing.
They don't know what to do except how to swindle people out of their droids, take them, and then just pawn them off as their own with bad motivators.
Okay, first of all, no. That's not the only thing they can do. They literally took down Mando.
They didn't take down Mando.
Yes, they did.
They temporarily stunned Mando.
They didn't only temporarily stun him.
They did take
tied
down
him up. They took his entire
They didn't
ship
tie
apart.
Him up.
Yes, they
no,
did.
They took apart his Razor Crest. Yes. But they didn't tie him up. They stunned him, and then he let them go, and then tracked them down and was just like, give me my shit. And then helped them out with their whole egg problem and got them delicious breakfast. So, if anything,
they do like eggs. That was kind of weird.
So... Okay, so what's your Jawa bringing to the fight besides this
it's
stunning
still,
of Amanda?
Okay, they are intelligent because they survive in the desert.
They decided
the desert
to,
is a first
they
of all,
decided
first of all,
to
first
live
all.
In a desert.
No,
not
they didn't
a smart
decide
idea.
To live in a desert. They didn't decide to live there. Their ancestors, I'm sure, decided to live there.
Well, then their ancestors weren't smart, then were they?
Okay, well, stop blaming ancestors for things. They did a lot of stupid shit. So, regardless. What was I saying? They
were talking about Jawas and why they're smart and living in the desert because of that.
That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying they can withstand really rough climates and they freaking, like, they don't just steal droids. They, like, put them up together and make new things and...
I don't know about that. They're a bunch of dumbos who just, like I said, let's put a new paint job on this droid and sell them to some dumbo on a
no, they farm. Do that because it's not profitable for them to do a good job on other people's
so
things.
Ewoks are legendary creatures, right? They live on the forest moon of Endor.
Okay.
In the Modell system. And it's a wonderful planet. It's filled with beautiful creatures, fauna, and
flora.
Flora, thank you.
You're welcome.
And so Ewoks are... First of all, Jawas have only been fucking destroyed on screen. The only time I've seen Jawas are, even though they're on screen, they're just, people are just kicking around their little, their carcasses like they're dirty rugs.
Just because they're only seen on screen a certain way.
Oh, guess what? Stormtroopers take them down, right? Stormtroopers take them down? And then what do Ewoks do? What's the Ewoks' entire purpose in Return of the Jedi? Destroying, taking down Stormtroopers, AT-ST walkers.
First of all, they're on the ready. They know what's coming. They're like, on their own home turf, they're prepared. The Ewoks.
They don't know nothing. What are you talking about? This rebellion was thrust onto their species without them knowing, just trying to get a snack. They caught a dumb Wookiee. Sorry, Chewbacca. And they just were going to serve them up.
Speaking of Wookiees, I looked up research on Wikipedia. Continue. I thought that was funny. Sorry.
So Ewoks, right? They craft weapons, spears, swords, bows, all types of catapults and shit, wooden log traps and shit like that. They're very, very primal with their attacks.
Not very effective, I'm sure.
And they're still technologically advanced, as we saw. They're able to man an AT-ST walker.
By luck.
A
monkey couldn't have done that on luck. There's literally no.
Yes. What do your Jawas? Okay. So, besides stormtroopers, what do your Jawas have to defend themselves from?
Humanoids.
So are Ewoks, and they're only a meter tall. Same height, same fucking humanoid thumbs and shit.
First of all, Jawas have their own, not only their own language, but they use their sense of smell to communicate.
So do Ewoks. Ewokies, study up.
Okay, well, I don't know every micro detail of the Star Wars universe.
So,
nerd alert.
What besides stormtroopers are taking down Jawas? What do they have to defend themselves from that will reciprocate into the Bite Club arena?
They don't fight very often unless they're swindling because they're in the desert.
So they're just a bunch of swindlers. Oh my God.
Oh my God is right. Tommy, no. They have to defend themselves against only the big, dragon. I'm sure you know this name, the sand dragon.
Okay, they don't have to defend themselves against crate dragons, is that what you're going for? Or sarlaccs, if that's what you're going for?
Yes, they do. They live in the desert.
Because everyone has to defend themselves from that. You can't, blanket term. That's like being they have to defend themselves from Darth Vader. Ever heard of him? He's a really bad guy. And he's so they're pretty strong because they have to plan to defend themselves from Darth Vader. Ever heard of him? Get out of here. See you,
and
dude.
And besides, where are we fighting? Because if we have
in the arena where there's going to be some sweet Endor redwoods, there's going to be some sweet sand.
There's going to be some spaceships around that I can pick from.
That's all right, fine. You want scrap metal? Sure.
Yes,
let's
some scrap
see what
metal.
You can do with your scrap metal, Jawas. Because guess what? Spoiler alert, it's going to be jack shit.
No, it's not
so,
jack shit.
So, besides the giant dragons that you claim are their only predator?
Okay, which...
Do they have any other predator?
Not really,
because
but...
Ewoks do. They have to defend themselves from lots of predators. That's why Ewoks live in treetops.
Because they're prey.
No.
Because they're prey.
No, because they're omnivores, and they can do some damage themselves, too. They'll swallow you whole. They'll eat a whole Wookiee! So, the reason why they live in treetops is because they need to defend themselves, right? They need to live in the... They need to keep themselves up high because a lot of the floor-dwelling forest moon creatures are super dangerous and super deadly. There's, Yummels or Yuzzums. Yuzzums, like the guy in the... He led Max Rebo's band on vocals. That guy chows down on Ewoks, so fuck that guy. Great song, but screw that guy. Then there's these other guys called Duloks, right? These guys are they look like little Grinch ass. They look like a Grinch knockoff. And then they hold up Ewoks and the only few images of them are them being I'll fucking kill this Ewok right now. And they're really weird. Holiday special. Grinch creatures that want to kill Ewoks.
There you go.
Lightsay special. So they didn't know how to defend themselves from, and these creatures are way bigger than Ewoks, so they have to defend themselves from creatures that are already bigger than them, which is probably why they were pretty good off against these stormtroopers, because they've had their experience
defending
with big
yourself
asshole
against
creatures.
A stormtrooper is really not that difficult.
Well, that would go against your argument because your Jawas got absolutely annihilated by
stormtroopers.
That's
only because, first of all, there was more of them, and second of all, because it was out of nowhere.
No, there were there was an army of Jawas littered on the ground, and it was only a few stormtroopers interrogating that sandcrawler for whatever knowledge they had on those stupid droids that they stole and pawned off as their own frickin' droids. Yo, oh my God, Waddle will be disgusting.
Listen, you're just mad because they have a skill that you don't have. It's almost like
what's that? Driving around a shit-ass sandcrawler quad that moves 2 miles per hour?
Okay, those giant sand crawlers can hold 1,500 droids that sure are
that
pretty
full.
That are
all stolen.
Yes, that's a skill. That's a flipping skill. They have a big sense of community, and they literally, do you actually know that Jawas get together once a year to have a salvage?
Wait, so you're talking about, you want to talk technology?
Yeah,
Jawa,
I do talk
Ewoks are able to man AT-ST walkers.
By luck alone.
And destroy AT-ST walkers along with the stormtroopers and stormtroopers on scout troopers on speeder bikes. Not by luck, by skill. They're able to walk around. They shoot. They aim at stormtroopers and help destroy. Chewbacca's in there helping them too, but they do it. They do it though.
Yeah, like I said, by luck alone.
Listen,
and
Ewoks
help.
Are deep creatures too. They hold religious, artistic, even political events, all right? So listen, these guys have a society that we're not even scratching the surface of, all right? We're not even scratching the surface of what these Ewoks are capable of, what they're capable of feeling, and how they're capable of annihilating an entire species, saving an entire galaxy, because guess what, people? Without the Ewoks taking down that forest moon shield on the Death Star, the second Death Star, guess what? Empire don't go down again. No new Force Awakens movie. Guess you gotta blame the Ewoks, I guess, if you hate these new movies. they made it happen. But yeah, guess what? Ewoks, you're welcome. You're welcome, everyone. Ewoks.
No.
Get walked.
Yeah, they're literally like teddy bears.
They're not.
They are, though.
They will eat your teddy bears. They'll probably eat a grizzly bear's
baby,
that's probably.
Freaking weird.
They would eat the shit out of all that stuff.
No.
So I think the Jawa would get in the arena, maybe ball out a stun gun, maybe. But I think an Ewok would have traps set. I think an Ewok would have weapons ready.
No way!
I think an Ewok would...
How would he have them ready? He gets dropped in at the same time, so then my Jawa has all this time to make his weapons.
Wrong. I think
make a droid to kill him.
No, I think Ewoks would use natural traps. So like they would find a log that's like near a hill and just kind of kick it. Give it a little nudge over the hill, and then it'll roll down and get him or something like that. I think they do some smart shit like that, where your Jawa would just
shit?
Your Jawa
you
would just be
shit?
Like, yeah, they would the Ewok would be at top of the hill, just be like, yeah, and just give him a little kick, and then your Jawa would be screwed. They'd be teeny in their way, back home, baby, because they have weapons, catapults, they create wing suits, they fly around with sweet like winged.
Tatooine had a lot of mean people and like really like crazy people on it. That like
Here we go again. Why are all of a sudden these specific people the dangerous to Jawas all of a sudden?
Well, probably because the Jawas are instigating. But I'm just saying they can handle themselves. That's all I'm saying.
Bike Club Podcast Life Day Special, it's coming at you hot and juicy. We don't care if you don't like it, we're gonna keep going with the holiday shit. I'm usually good at... Stop it, that was good. It should have been
better
at the end.
That was a repeat, essentially, so...
Whatever.
I mean, I liked it. I still liked it.
I'm not gonna even sing at all now.
Oh my god, don't be a Scrooge.
Nice.
Thanks.
Nice.
Thanks.
Star Wars Special, guys. Let us know. Who you got?
Let it snow. Wow, I'm like...
We're on a roll. We're on a roll. Star Wars, baby. Yeah, let us know if you're going with the Ewoks.
Do I have to put mine on?
Definitely.
Oh my God.
Are you going with Ewoks? Duh.
No.
Look, turn off your talking computer. I know. That's not the line.
That was fun to say.
I know. Shit.
You're so silly.
Ewoks or Jawas? These feel really tight. I feel like this? I look like Porkins is what I look like right now.
I'm having
a little trouble here.
What do I look like? How do I look?
You look hot. I hate it. I look like Porkins. You look like fucking Babe Poe.
Thanks.
All right, let us know. Ewoks or Jawas? Life Day Special Super Roxin, it's super hot and juicy. I'm doing it a third time, I don't care. Say it. Star Wars! Star Wars!
My clunky. I'm blue.